As the people of Tamil Nadu continue to rebuild after last December's devastating tsunami, the ocean has begun to offer up more than just destruction and heartbreak. Just a short distance from the discovery of a centuries-old city at Mahabalipuram, archaeologists have made another stunning find.
I heard legends since I was a child about the giant creatures that once lived here, but now it seems those stories are true.
Half buried in the sand and stretching 150 feet beneath the ocean lies something that may change paleontologists' understanding of prehistoric biology. Archaeologists are excavating what appears to be the fossilized remains of a giant creature. As yet unidentified, the remains are being examined to help scientists solve this colossal mystery. For Shreyas News India,
this is Shalom. I'm the brother Uramia from Toronto Prophets. I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai and double honors to the elders of GMS whom I learned the truth from, and Shalom to the elect, the true men of the Lord pushing the truth. Alright, the title of this lesson is The Big Fish Phenomenon. Okay, or the big whale phenomenon. Alright, like you got these assholes out there, son netter, you know, bro polite, which are just scheming for money. Alright, they want to laugh at the works of the Most High. That's fine.
Listen, the fish thing is, we got to get back to that. We got to find another day for this fish conversation. You know what I'm saying? Y'all not getting away with the big fish.
We going to something else.
Y'all not going to get away with that.
Let me read this. There's an entity.
Y'all almost have it, too. Y'all should have never read that fish verse. I was about to convert.
Too much.
Alright? I was about to convert into the fish.
Well, if the Lord wants you, wait a minute.
The Lord was with me up until the point. Let me, brother.
You know, we're going to see if they laugh at the work that Yahweh Hashem Yahushai is bringing to America, you know, which is martial law, the chip. Okay, we're going to see who's going to have the last laugh. Alright, so without further ado, I'm going to go into this, what the Lord showed me. Alright, so let's go to Jonah 1 and go straight to the point. This is after the shipwreck and the men on board. The men on board the ship that Jonah was on to go to Tarshish, which is Spain, they threw him off the ship. Alright, and the storm ceased. So this is verse 17. It says, now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. Now you see, a lot of people say, oh, it's a great whale or whatever. Let's examine the Hebrew, something that a lot of these groups, other groups, don't do. Okay, fish right here, the word there is dag in the Hebrew, dag. All right and when we look it up, fish, all right down here it says fish, so called from being so wonderfully prolific. All right so it simply means fish. So a whale in Esau's taxonomy, which is his way of categorizing animals and species, a whale is a mammal, a fish is his own category, which is like a shark, etc. Alright, those are fishes. So on that base, it's we can see it's not a whale. Alright, now let's go to the one scripture where it actually mentions whale, Jonah being eaten by the whale. Alright, it actually has the name whale there. Matthew 12 and 40. Alright, because these guys laugh at the work of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, but the Most High is the great architect. He can do whatever he wants, man. You know, he has there's no limit to his power. Alright. So as you see here, it says Matthew 12 and 40. First, Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the whale's belly. So shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Now, when you look up the word whale here in the Greek, the word is ketos. All right. Satan's trying to slow the progression. So what does it mean? It means a sea monster. A whale, huge fish. So here's another, there's a different perspective right here. A sea monster. Just like Eleazar was saying, get Job 41 in the highways when they had the debate. Leviathan. It could have very well been Leviathan. We don't know. All right. It could be a whale. There could, like the elder said, Esau doesn't know shit, man. He thinks he knows each a category of whale, each category of fish. The demon that the father of taxonomy, if you look, like I said, if you look up taxonomy, it means an arrangement. That's your reptiles, your mammals, your fish, etc. That the devil was, I believe his name is Carolus something. All right, he was the devil. He's known as the father of taxonomy. Now he was also the guy that divided mankind into four color lines. You know, your white, your red, your yellow, etc. All right, and his protege was this guy Johann F. Blumenbach, which is the devil, which he really set up that line of dividing men according to color line. So Esau has his own color line, or it's like Esau has his own way of categorizing fish and doing this and that. But the Most High has animals and creatures that these devils never seen before, man. You know, Esau's in search of the bottom of the sea, like Eleazar said in the video. All right. So they could very well, like Polite said, we know that a whale can only swallow this and that. He can't swallow man. Well, we know. I like how he says, we know. You don't know shit, man. The white man doesn't know shit. By you saying, we know, you don't know, man. All right? You guys don't know. There could be a whale out there that can swallow a man whole. All right? You think you know every single species and this and that. I bet you niggas didn't even know that dinosaurs were still around, man. There's still dinosaurs on the planet Earth, man. The Most High has everything reserved, man. Alright, that's why they make those movies on the different creatures. You got Loch Ness. You know, you got, they made that movie, what is it, Anaconda. You know, that big ass snake. Alright. So here's a good perspective. So Ketos, which means sea monster. So here we just jumped into a whole nother field, man. Okay, so that was the root word. So I looked up the word keto in Wikipedia because I thought it was worth a Google, and I found out it was worth a Google. It actually is a mythological, they say, creature. So here's keto from Wikipedia. Keto, literally in Greek meaning sea monster, is a primordial sea goddess. All right, in Greek mythology, Keto was also variously called Critias and Trineus, which Critias means mighty and Trineus means within 3 years, and was occasionally conflated by scholars with the goddess Hesate. All right, so this was a goddess that they worshipped in the form of a sea creature, because they actually seen these sea creatures back in the ancient world. There's accounts of that. And here's another spelling of it, Cetus or Ketus. Alright. In ancient Greek, the word ketos denotes a large fish, a whale, a shark, or a sea monster. Alright. The sea monsters slain by Perseus and Heracles were each referred to as Cetus or Ketus by ancient sources. Alright, in Greek art, Cetia were depicted as a serpentine fish. The name of the mythological figure Seto is derived from Ketos and mythology. So in the Bible it says in Jonah 2:1, 1:17 in English translation, the Hebrew text reads Dag Gadol. Alright, which literally means great fish. The Septuagint translates this phrase into Greek as mega ketos. The term ketos alone means huge fish. And in Greek mythology, the term is closely associated with sea monsters. It says Jerome later translated this phrase as piscis grandis in his Latin Vulgate. However, he translated the Greek word ketos as cetus in Gospel of Matthew 12:40, which we read. Alright, so there you go, it means a sea monster, and you damn sure you should know that a sea monster definitely can eat up a man. All right, and when you look up kettles in Google, just to type it in pictures, you get some things like this. All right, like they're talking about the vase, dragon. All right, sea monsters, sea dragons. All right, you get stuff like this basically, okay, which is Cetus. All right.